Up behind them in the fourth position, but all six boats are going to be up there. It is going to be Jesse Robertson going to get up there in lane number one, but they've got 30 seconds to kill now. Nobody can go below 80 miles an hour. 28 seconds to go. Everybody up in the north turn. Watch Robertson. He's in a great position, but I think he might be too early. He's going to have to scruff off boat speed, but he can't go below 80 miles an hour, and everybody's coming off the corner with 15 seconds on the clock. The accelerators are being retarded. It looks like Jesse may get across the line. We're still 6 seconds till the start. They're crawling up here. Now they start to accelerate. 1 second. Mark, and we are racing. Jimmy Shane's got boat speed. So does Cal Phipps on the outside. Jimmy Shane's going to bring him down. Jesse Robertson's way out in front, but we believe he may have beat the clock and got across the line. We'll watch them as they come out of the corner. Who's going to make the turn first? It is going to be, it is Jimmy Shane on the outside. Then he's got J. Michael Kelly on his left, and then Scott Lidicote is on the inside. There is a one-lap penalty on the seven. One lap penalty on the seven, otherwise the start looks good. Gary, take him up through the upper corner.
The Alberto is in front then, and that puts J. Michael Kelly inside of him, but he is now going to cut a much shorter course, and J. Michael Kelly is probably going to come out of this north turn in the lead, and on the inside of them is Scott Lidicote, so watch how it looks coming down the front straightaway. Jean Theoret is outside of both of them. Alberto and J. Michael Kelly side by side.
This is a great boat race coming out here with one in the books and four to go. It is J. Michael Kelly. It is Jimmy Shane, and then it is Jean Theoret. 1, 2, 3. They're chasing Robertson, and Robertson is trying to hug the buoy line and stay out of their way. He's doing a good job of it, and off the corner down the backstretch, it is J. Michael Kelly, Gary.
J. Michael Kelly in the Graham Trucking. It looks like it is impressive. Going up the back straightaway at really fast speed. The Alberto is right on his outside, and Jean Theoret trying to keep up with them both, but I don't think he can do it. Right now, J. Michael Kelly is putting it to it, and Jimmy Shane is right on his hip as they come out of the north turn. You are going to see a beautiful sight of boats side by side. On the inside, Jesse Robertson, he is a lap down. That is a Graham Trucking to J. Michael Kelly, and Jimmy Shane right beside him, and they are going to shoot at all. It's a drag race to the start-finish line to see who's going to lead at the end of this lap.
Two up, two down, three to go still. It is J. Michael Kelly by two boat lengths on Jimmy Shane and the Alberto. What a boat race. This is going to be a barn burner. We are on lap number three. They are in the south turn. They have cleared Jesse Robertson, and now our two leaders can just settle down and have their shootout, and it is J. Michael Kelly by a couple of boat lengths on Shane, Gary.
J. Michael Kelly in the Graham Trucking doing it again like he did last year. He's got Jimmy Shane on his outside and the Alberto, and he's keeping him on his hip. The Graham Trucking is showing us all they've got, and they have really exploded here in the final heat. J. Michael Kelly getting around everybody. He is in lane two. Now he is sliding out and pushing Jimmy Shane and the Alberto probably out to lane 3.5.
Coming down to complete lap number three. We'll have two more to go. This is as good as it gets at the Albert Lee Cup at Seafair. J. Michael Kelly on the inside. Shane does not want to let him go. It's still a 2.5, maybe a 3-boat length lead for Kelly, but it is still anybody's boat race. There is no traffic for them to come up on. It is just the two of them to set this up and finish these two laps at the exit pin of the corner. It is J. Michael Kelly in the Graham Trucking. Still got about 2.5 boat lengths on Jimmy Shane, Gary.
Yes. Still tucked in his rooster tail. The Alberto does not want to give up on the Albert Lee Appliance Cup. Jimmy Shane is really pushing it all he can to catch up with J. Michael Kelly in the Graham Trucking as they approach the north turn, and the floating bridge is looking beautiful right now because J. Michael Kelly in the Graham Trucking is hanging it all out. Jimmy Shane is right on his hip. They are still within a rooster tail, and here comes the J. Michael Kelly piloted Graham Trucking. Jimmy Shane is still right beside him. He has got more speed as he gets to the end of the straightaway, but man, it is impressive as they finish this lap. Alberto closing it up.
He is closing it up. The white flag lap, one to go. Shane's going to get down here. One boat length as they get to the entrance pin. It is the last lap. This is one of the better final heats in Seattle Seafair history. They are really out here racing. They have just over a half a lap to go. It is Kelly off the corner. It is Shane right with him. A boat length and a half, Gary. Take him up north.
The Graham Trucking does not want to give away to the Alberto. Graham Trucking, J. Michael Kelly wants to win the Albert Lee Appliance Cup again, and Jimmy Shane is closing up again. He is really close as they come out of the north turn. This is going to be a drag race to the finish. Oh boy, Alberto and the Graham trucking here they side come. By side.
Off the corner. It is Shane on the outside trying to make a run. It is going to be Jimmy Shane. Shane has got him. He has done it. Holy cow. What a boat race we just saw. Unbelievable. Oh, Gary Scheib.
Move over, rover. Oh. Let Jimmy Shane take over. The old boy Oberto on the last half of the last lap puts it down against J. Michael Kelly and the Graham Trucking to show us all what boat racing is all about. From the outside of the Graham Trucking, the Oberto put it all together on that last half of that last lap. What a finish.
I made a comment that this is one of the greatest final heats in Seattle Seafair racing history. I will still stand by that comment. I don't know that we've ever had one quite like that. That was absolutely as good as it gets.
Wow. Well, we will hope to talk to the winner soon as Jimmy Shane and it looks like folks at Graham. I think we have a little discrepancy here about what.
There was some talk of a penalty. There was some talk of a penalty on the one for encroaching on the five. Apparently, that message has definitely found its way up and down pit row because you just saw J. Michael Kelly come out and jump up on the top of the air scoop, put his fist up in the air. And oh, my goodness, the disappointment that must be down at the north end of the pit area. Apparently, it occurred on lap four. That's what we are being told. Alex, I know you're listening to us. I know you're down there. If you're out there by the Oberto, you need to find your way
to the Graham Trucking.
You need to find your way over to J. Michael Kelly and the Graham Trucking. You'll be able to find them. There is quite a party going on over there on the dock.